So what is the best way to scan for squeezes in the Thinkorswim platform? In this video, I'm going to walk you through how to set up your scan so you can quickly and easily find the best squeezes for your trading. Hey, how's it going? On this channel, you will learn the steps it takes to make a full-time income trading in the stock market. So if you're new here, consider subscribing. And today, we're setting up scans for the squeeze indicator. So if you're new to setting up scans in the Thinkorswim, I'm not gonna walk through all the basics, but I will walk through everything in setting up this scan for the squeeze. Now, right now we're in the monitor tab. You're gonna wanna go over to the scan tab, and then you'll see there are a few tabs in the scan tab. So we are gonna be under the stock hacker or stock scanner tab, and that's where we're gonna have this set up. So now I already have this scan set up, but I'm gonna walk you through the settings of it and why I have them, and then also setting up the actual squeeze indicator alert scan, because that can be kind of confusing. So these first two right here are actually stock filters. So for the scanner, you can set up different kind of filters. Up here you can see that there are filters for stocks, there is a study filters, and then there's also filters for options and then fundamentals. And the first two I like to put are for market cap and then volume. And so what these do is they make sure I am looking at stocks that are a decent size and that they also have a good amount of trading volume, so I know that they are a strong company and that there's liquidity and people trading it. You don't really want to be trading a stock that no one's trading, because that can just cause a lot of different issues that I'm not going to go into in this video. And then you just want to filter by market cap also, because generally the smaller market cap stocks will have liquidity or volume issues as well. And we're more looking for trading large or very strong trending growth stocks with decent size. So what I have for the market cap size is a billion. So it's essentially, if the company is a billion or larger in market cap, the scan will pick those up. And then for volume, I have a kind of an arbitrary number. It's not set in stone, but roughly about 400,000. You could do 500,000 or even 1 million shares. And so this is traded a day. So generally these companies, if they're traded that many shares a day, they definitely have enough liquidity for you not to have issues. Now this can sometimes knock out some larger cap companies that have a large share price that trade small amount of shares, just because their share value is so big. Generally those are hard to trade anyway with either options or shares, because they cost so much to trade anyway. I'm okay avoiding those. Now the next one is the actual squeeze indicator alert, and I'm just gonna walk you through how to set that up, because there are a few settings in here that you can't see that are important to making sure it works properly. So what you're gonna wanna do to add this is you wanna go to add study filter, because this is a study. And then down here, you'll see that it brings that up, and we're gonna wanna go to custom. And then we'll delete what it default puts in and then add condition. And that's just adding a new study. And so we wanna click on add study, and then we wanna look up study. And so I'm just gonna type in squeeze, and then there it comes up. And you wanna make sure that it plots the squeeze alert. And so that's gonna be those red dots in the squeeze. And so that's what we're looking for. We wanna know when it's in a squeeze. And all these other settings are fine to just leave on the default. You just wanna make sure you change the plot to squeeze alert. And then we wanna set is equal to, and then it'll bring up a condition, and then click value. And we wanna make sure that value is zero. Now within bars is, because this is gonna be a daily scan, this will just say that within the last bar or the most recent bar or today's bar, it is showing that is in a squeeze. We're looking for stocks that are currently in a squeeze. We wanna leave this at within one bar. All that is saying is that within the last bar or the most recent bar, it is showing that is in a squeeze. And that's all we're looking for here, is we're looking for stocks currently in a squeeze so we can look for them in a trade. Now, these are all the settings for it. We're just gonna click save and then click okay. And that's gonna add that down here. Now, I'm just gonna exit this because I already have it up here, but that's all the settings you need for that. The rest of these are all moving average scans, so all you're going to do is just add study filter and then make sure you find moving average scan and then change those to the settings that I have here. Now these are just exponential moving averages, and all these scans are doing is seeing that the stock is above these moving averages. Now you will see that over here on the right, I have a moving averages for daily and then also weekly moving averages. And so all these are doing is for the weekly ones, it's saying that, okay, on a weekly chart, the stock is trading above the 21 EMA and the 8 EMA. And so this is saying that on a weekly chart, the stock is trending well. And then on these daily charts, this is showing that it's above the 34 EMA and then the 200 and the 55. These are much larger moving averages. But again, with this scan, all I'm trying to do is seeing if it's in a squeeze and if the overall trend is really strong. So these are all the settings, and then we can click down here, scan, and it will scan and find all these stocks in a squeeze. Now, the best part about this is you don't have to look at these and then click on charts and then type them in. You can tell it to add into a watch list. So over here on the top right of this, we're going to click and save as watch list. And then this is going to go in a watch list that we can look at while we're looking at charts. So I'm just going to put in daily squeeze test here and then click save. And that's going to save as a watch list for us. And then going back quickly to show you something up here, you want to make sure that the squeeze is in a daily, because right now we're just scanning for daily charts. You can change this to different time frames. So if you're looking for smaller squeezes or longer term time frame squeezes, you can. Sadly, you can't change this to custom time frames like 195 minute squeezes or 78 minute squeezes. You can't do that here. I have called them and tried to see if you can, but there's no settings in the platform at the moment to do that. Now that we have this squeeze saved, we can go into charts and start looking at our watch list and scanning for squeezes and checking out squeezes that our watch list has brought up. So over here on the left, I have watch lists, and then I'm going to click on this little tab it has, and then it's going to bring up personal. And so here are all the personal watch lists that I can have. And then we're just going to go to daily squeeze test. And so see that watch list changed here. And a quick thing you want to make sure you do is right here, you'll see that normally it'll look like this. You'll have the little link here. You want to make this link the same color as the link on your chart. And all this does is that it allows you to link your watch list and your chart so you can quickly click on your watch list over here without having to type in the ticker up here. You just can click on this and quickly scan through these stocks. And that's the best part of having this watch list set up, is all the scan does is tell me if it's in a daily squeeze and if it's in a strong uptrend, but it doesn't scan exactly for what I'm looking for. Now, I haven't tweaked with the scan to find the exact perfect setup every time, but that's okay, because for me, I can quickly look at the 50 to 100 stocks that this scan shows, and I can quickly find, you know, 5 or 10 that I want to start watching and look for entries in trades. Now, you can try and tweak with the scan setup to maybe find less squeezes, but once you get really good at this, it'll take you about 2 seconds to look at a chart and to know that, okay, I do like this squeeze or I don't like this squeeze. The whole idea of the scan is just to find squeezes in long uptrends, so you're not looking through thousands of stocks, because there will always be plenty of stocks in squeezes, but quite often a lot of them won't work very well. The squeeze is a continuation indicator, and we want to find stocks that are in a strong uptrend looking for that next continuation leg higher. So to quickly look at a few of these, we can see this first one actually is Apple. And right now you can see that down here, it is in a squeeze based on those red dots. Now it's been in a squeeze for the last few days, and sadly it has earnings. But other than that, this Apple does look pretty good to the upside with this kind of overall bull flag pattern and then the squeeze setting up. Now, this isn't the greatest setup just because it's been really choppy for a while, so I wouldn't necessarily take this trade, but it's definitely one to keep an eye on for. Now, moving down the list, we'll just take a look at a few more of these. Now, I don't really like this one because it's a little too choppy and we have earnings right around the gate. Quite a few of these have earnings coming up and we are in earnings season. So a lot of those squeezes or all of them, I won't take. I don't like taking trades and holding through earnings because for me, earnings is kind of a crapshoot and it's essentially just gambling. You don't know if the stock's gonna go up or down after earnings. And the main point with this trading strategy is going off what the chart is telling you, and the chart can be telling you one thing and then earnings can come out and tell you a complete different thing. And this chart right here has earnings as well, and after earnings it could be down all the way down here at $13, and right now this chart looks great. We have that general pattern of the stock just made a strong up move and then it's selling off a little bit. It's beginning to start that flag out and consolidation period, and then you have that squeeze. And so this would be a stock that if it didn't have earnings right here, you see earnings by this red and blue little circle, and this would be great candidate for potentially looking for a move up here to, you know, 15.5, or just, you know, a continuation move higher. And that's what you're looking for with these trades, is these general strong up move and then kind of consolidation period followed by the squeeze forming, and that's when you want to be looking to get in. But again, we have earnings here and I don't like holding through earnings. You're welcome to, but I wouldn't suggest it. It can definitely be a coin flip very frequently. You will also have a problem with, if you are trading options, you will have a volatility crush as the earnings come out. So if you have calls, they will decrease in value even if the stock doesn't move at all, just because of that volatility crush. Now, if you don't know what that is, I would very highly recommend not holding the options through earnings. I would definitely look that kind of stuff up before you try and trade stuff and hold options through earnings. Also, what this scan does is, as you can see on this chart, this stock over the last year has just gone basically up. And that is generally what I'm looking for with these kind of trades. I'm looking for to see the stock have a very strong uptrend, and then, you know, this just general flag out move and then the squeeze develop. It shows you that this stock is very strong and that it is highly likely it is going to keep going up. And all the squeeze does is tell you when there's a consolidation period and when is there a very strong time for you to get in and buy before it makes that next move higher. Now you can see there are a ton of stocks in here that we can go and look through, and generally they are showing this upward trend over the last year and then kind of this flag out. Now this kind of squeeze right here, you can see it's been essentially squeezing for the last, you know, month or two, and that's definitely not what I'm looking for. You're wanting to see something that squeezes and then in a few days takes off. So you want to be finding these pretty quickly. And so generally, if you're trading these, you're going to want to be looking at this scan and scanning for new squeezes pretty frequently, because the strong stocks will go into a squeeze only for a few days and then continue higher. So you don't want to be trading these stocks that have this kind of setup where they'll go up and then sit there for 2 months. Now, if you're trading a longer term time frame, if you're, you know, just wanting to buy stock and hold it for a few months, this stock looks great, right? This last squeeze right here, you can see it flagged out and then, you know, took off and did great over the last few months. And then now it's kind of doing that same thing. It's flagging out. You see this kind of squeeze here. It looks like it's going to start maybe making that leg higher. It made new highs 2 days ago. And so maybe it's going to start going up again and then make a similar move to this. Now, you don't necessarily know that, of course, but generally it is a pretty good indicator, and that's all trading is making educated guesses that a stock is gonna do what you want. Now, you might wanna make a watch list with just stocks that you wanna be generally looking at consistently and seeing when they go in squeezes. Now, you might wanna be looking that if they're, you know, in a daily squeeze, a 195 minute squeeze or a few hour squeeze, all the time, because they're such strong stocks. Now, a stock like this could be like Amazon or Google or any of the really large cap stocks that are trending and growing really well. Those stocks can be amazing for squeezes. Now, another one or another list of stocks that is really strong is the IBD 50, the Investors Business Daily 50. Now, This stock list you actually do have to pay for, but I will say that there is an ETF that follows the stock list exactly, and you can look at what stocks are in that ETF exactly. I don't remember the ticker, but all you need to do to get that list without paying for it is just look for the IBD 50 ETF, and you will be able to see every stock that is in the IBD 50 without having to pay, you know, I think it's like $30 a month for that list. So that is another strong list of stocks, because those are the top 50 growth stocks in their mind. And I have used that list before, and generally it is very powerful in looking for stocks. Now, what you're going to want to do with those is you can put those in a watch list, and I actually have a watch list with those. And then what you can do is, in another video, I'll show you how to set up a watch list that'll, in the watch list, show you that if it's in a daily 4 hour, 2 hour, 1 hour, 30 minute squeeze, without having to scan and look at the stocks. On the watch list, it'll just say yes or no, or green or red if it's in a squeeze. And so that can be really powerful for looking at pre-made watch lists like this, like the IBD 50, and can save you a ton of time when scanning for these squeezes. So thanks for checking out this video. If you want to learn more about that squeeze watch list, I'll make sure to put a link to that right here. Now, if you want to just learn more about the stock market, make sure to subscribe. And if you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comments below.